Every product has a story. The raw materials that made it, the route it traveled during development, the people who sourced, constructed, and handled it. At Free2Work, we endeavor to understand how brands can ensure humane employment for their workers. To reveal the likelihood that their products are made with forced or child labor, and to influence consumers by disclosing our research. We base our research on public information and on data reported by the brands themselves.
Our first stage of research involves risk analysis. Using reports from the U.S. Department of Labor, we assess the risk levels for forced or child labor within certain countries or industries. We grade brands that operate in high-risk areas on a stricter scale than those that operate in a low-risk area. If a brand does not disclose where they operate, we grade them on the high-risk scale. In the second stage of our research, we identify the three main stages of a product's development. Some product supply chains are extremely complex and involve a variety of different actors and are produced in a plethora of different countries. Other product supply chains are not that dynamic, and they are produced close to where they are sold. To manage this variety of different types of supply chains, we identify the three main stages of production: the raw materials, the inputs, and the manufacturing. At each of these three stages, we grade a brand's efforts to address trafficking by examining their policies, their traceability and transparency, their supply chain monitoring, and their worker rights. A brand's most basic step to ensure the decency of its supply chain is to create strong written policies based on the principles of the International Labor Organization. A brand should also take steps to protect vulnerable workers within the supply chain, such as those that are laboring in remote areas or contracted laborers. In order to implement its policies, a brand must know its supply chain. Many brands only engage their final stage production, but trafficking is most prevalent in the remote areas of the supply chain. So we look for a brand to understand its supply chain thoroughly, and we look for a brand to disclose this information publicly. Next, we evaluate a brand's monitoring program to protect its workers. Better monitoring programs include unannounced visits to factories and off-site worker interviews. Finally, we assess a brand's empowerment of its workers. We look for a brand to ensure free association of its workers and to pay workers a living wage. Through free2work.org and the Free2Work app, we provide our research to consumers. Our hope is that this information will inform purchasing decisions and motivate brands to improve. Together, we can end slavery in our lifetime.